In the first assignment, we have to help Vega. So Vega has recently finished her undergraduate degree in finance and has landed a job as analyst in the listed company Classic, which produces beer and soft drinks. Vega puts together a personal budget in her new job situation. She uses finance theory to answer the questions below. So the first question we have to look at, we have to look at a future value. When finding a future value, if you remember from the theory video, we have to compound the value forward, or discount forward, as a lot of people say in practice. We can see here that Vega has deposited 14,000 kroner into a separate savings account. The account pays 3% annual return. She leaves the money in the savings account for 4 years. So what we are looking at here is not an annuity and it's not a perpetuity. So the only thing left it could be, according to our theory, is that it's a cash flow stream. But this one is pretty easy because we just have one cash flow, which means that we have to just forward discount or compound the cash flow for the specific number of years. So when finding a future value, we apply the formula here. But let's first get in the information. So the first one here is called future value. We can see from the assignment that the value today, so it was deposited in 14,000 kroner. So we can say that the present value at time zero, that equaled 14,000. We also know that the interest rate equaled 3%. And we know that she leaves the money in the account for 4 years. So 3%. And periods, that's our T, that was 4 years. So having this data in here, we can actually find the future value. Always remember to state what time you're looking at. So no matter if you're using WordMat or Excel to calculate this, remember to state that we are finding the future value at time 4. So to do that, I apply my formula from here. A good way to sort of implement notes in the calculations you do is maybe to copy in the formula next to where you're using it. So like this. Then you can always come back to this assignment and say, what did we actually do? I'll just leave room here for a conclusion. So the future value must be the present value here. So that's the first element of my formula, multiplied by 1 plus the rate into the power of t. And that gives me a result that after 4 years, Vega has saved up 15,757.12 kroner. Always remember to write a short conclusion. Vega has saved up 15,755.12 kroner in the end of year 4. So that would be the answer to the first assignment. We moved the value from present value, so something that was deposited into the account today, and 4 years forward. Then we are ready to go to the next question, which is called present value. So let's just read the assignment. It says, which amount should Vega deposit into her new savings account today if she wants to have 19,000 kroner available at the end of year 4? We can already see that if she wants 19,000 kroner, she must deposit more than 14,000 at least, because depositing 14,000 only gave her 15,757. So that's a good check to do, that when we start to calculate, does it actually make sense? It only does if we end up with a value here that is larger than 14,000. So once again, we can say, okay, well, these two elements didn't change, right? So it's still 4 years. The interest rate is still 3%. So what does actually change? Our future value at time 4. That must equal 19,000 now. And now we have to find the present value at time 0. And instead of compounding or forward discounting, we simply discount the 19,000 back to time 0. So let's just get the formula copied in. So this is the present value. And the reason why I always copy in these formulas is that when I then sit at the exam, I can quickly see, okay, what was it actually I did here? And I have the formula available just next to it. For those of you who use Word Math or Math Type, it is even easier to do this. So this is a little bit time consuming to copy these in Excel, but they're just really good to have next to your calculations. So now we can find the present value at time 0. That must be the amount that she has to deposit. Because if we then compound that forward, we will reach 19,000. So I will use the first one here, where I simply use a divide. So that must be 19,000, that is the future value, divided by 1 plus the interest rate into the power of t. So the result here is 16,881.25. That means that if Vega deposits in this amount into her savings account, she will reach 19,000 by the end of year 4. So the conclusion could be Vega has to deposit 16,881.25 kroner into her savings account today. And one check that could be good to do is to see if we insert the value here in our first assignment, would we actually reach 19,000 here? So what you can do in Excel is that you can copy this one, so copy, and you can go up here and say insert value. And if you do that, you can see we reached 19,000. And that was our goal. Just remember that when you have done this check, to regret your calculation, so you go back and have the correct result for the first assignment again. So that was the two first questions here that were relatively simple. It could be that you would have a stream of cash flows instead, where you have to replicate these two calculations a lot of times. But the good thing in Excel is that you only have to type it once, and then you can copy the formula down. So that was question 1 and 2.